am Manuela Bonanno from Columbia University, here interviewing Julie Costanzo for the Radiation Research Society podcast or vodcast. So Julie, please introduce yourself, tell me where you're from and where you're working right now.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Manuela. I'm Julie Costanzo. I'm working in Strasbourg University in France, in CNRS, at Institut Pluridisciplinaire Hubert Curien.
So Julie, you are presenting a poster here, and it's about a preclinical proton machine.
Yes.
And well, tell us more about it, because I think we know that proton therapy, carbon therapy are working very well in patients, but unfortunately we don't know why. We don't know the biological mechanism. So machines, preclinical data are really needed. So tell me more about your machine and what is special about this proton machine and how do you characterize it?
Okay, so just to begin a bit forward, I performed my PhD in Lyon to build a proton beamline with low energy protons and 3 MeV protons. So to study high LET exactly, thank you, on cancer cells. Then I moved in Sherbrooke University to where I performed more applications on radiation necrosis effects on the rat brain after gamma knife irradiation. So there I performed more dosimetric evaluation on how to perform a proper irradiation for small animals. And then I moved back in France, where I developed with my team a 25 MeV proton beamline, because as you said, it's still complicated to identify patients who will benefit from proton therapy treatment. So yes, basically with this beamline, this proton beamline offer a large range of LET for cancer cells irradiation, for example, from 2 kV per micrometer to 8 kV per micrometer, which are LET of interest in clinic, because as you know probably this is the LET that are in the brain tumor, for example.
So needless to say, you are able to reach ranges that will allow you to really reach a tumor.
In small animals, because 25 MeV protons are 6 millimeter path in water, so it's a bit tricky for dosimetry, but still it offers the possibility to target very small tumors in the mice, or subcutaneous tumors, or in the mouse brain, for example. So very, very targeted, and also low depth in tissues, as we as encountered in small animals.
So how do you set up your validation of the dosimetry? Well, first, the characterization. And then, how did you validate?
Yes, it's very challenging because there is no standard dosimetric tools for 25 MeV protons, and nobody to compare my result. Almost nobody. Few teams that I cite in few articles. And so, I used EBT3 films because they have a good response at 25 MeV protons, but not below this energy, not below 20 MeV, sorry. And also I tried to test a new detector, a CMOS sensor, which is a silicon pixelated detector, and that was developed for certain experiments for high energy particles, so not all.
And it gives you the dose response?
Exactly, I can have the lateral dose response, but with the technology that I have now, I cannot really measure the percentage depth dose, so we developed it at IPHC in Strasbourg, a new CMOS sensor that will help to measure along the Bragg peak. So it's basically that for the moment, and I look forward to other teams who are working with low energy protons for maybe sharing data and, you know, and maybe try their dosimetric tools, for example.
And so, at the moment, is the machine ready to go? I mean,
yes.
Can be used, and would it be available, if so, to users?
Yes, exactly. Yes, we are already working with a Belgium team for irradiate mice, and we are already irradiate our own mice on hepatocarcinoma cancer on subcutaneous model. And we are performing PET imaging to see the response with the dose response between 10 and 30 grays irradiation.
And so your background is physics,
yes.
Right? Are you involved also in the biological experiments?
Yes, yes, I am. I am trying to, I'm starting a new studies on cells irradiation, so it's really preliminary. It's not, you know, it's gonna work.
And which endpoint are you going to look at?
What I would like to look at is proteomic response, you know, just irradiate cells with different doses.
Different LEDs.
Yes, and different LEDs, and check exactly what proteins are overexpressed or upregulated or downregulated because of the dose and the LET, for
so
example.
So eventually you want to apply like a proteomic approach?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Because in Strasbourg we have a lab of proteomics which is well known in France, and we are starting a collaboration on that topic.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
And then I believe with your background in physics, you will be able to, you know, manage big data, do like a deep analysis.
Probably, I have to learn.
You learn,
yes,
you learn,
yes,
even
yes.
If you, there is no choice, right?
Yes,
we have, as physicists working with biology or mm-hmm. vice versa, mm-hmm. you have to learn a little bit the language.
Yes, and I like it.
Collaborators.
That's
the best.
Yes, right?
So, any other kind of, I don't know if it's an upgrade, but any other, yeah, let me call it, upgrade of this machine you guys are planning to do, or at the moment you're thinking of just doing experiments?
No, we are already working on developing a second beam line, probably that will couple with a SARP system as Eric Ford did in Seattle, Washington, Seattle. That could be great to have an image-guided irradiation setup. We want also develop more animal models or, you know, irradiation, like flash irradiation. We are able to do this with our machine. We can go up to 50 grays per second, so we could study this with proton ions, So it could be great because it's not possible yet in clinics, so
no,
why not starting?
Right? Yeah, exactly. It's possible. I think there is plenty of information and
yeah.
fantastic experiments with X-rays,
exactly.
But not much with
yes.
protons. They have tried cell work with protons, but then it didn't go further for probably the range limitation,
exactly.
Something that you can overcome. Julie, who are your collaborators? Do you want to acknowledge the people in your lab working
yes.
on your project?
Yes, I want to acknowledge Marc Rousseau, the chair of our department, who is in charge of the proton beamline. Also Marie Van Staal with and Christian Fink with I'm working on analogical treatment planning system that we developed for the irradiation and all the calculation topics for properly irradiate and dosimetry and stuff like this, and all the team in my lab for sure, and people in radiation biology and imaging, molecular imaging.
Yes. So I believe in the like near future, you will still be working on this project. So you will be busy for a while in this laboratory.
Yes.
So anything else that you would like to add regarding your project?
No.
Okay, that's perfect. Yeah. So Julie, thank you so much for
taking the time to talk
to us about your work, and I hope next year to talk to you about some mice experiments, some data on the biological application. But anyhow, congratulations for this machine, because it's needed.
Yes.
We need it already for like a long time. So
thank you very much.
I wish you great success.